Superman.
Superman. Superman.
Superman.
You wanted to see me?
He was the world's first comic book superhero. The fearless man in blue tights, with a red cape and an S stretched boldly across his chest.
My dad would give me a dime to buy every new issue of Superman.
Superman made a big impact on me, and I guess on most of the people who read him.
For more than 60 years, Superman has been everything. From a comic book, to a cartoon, to a movie star.
Easy, miss. I've got you.
Everybody, when they talk about Superman as part of their childhood, glows about why it's such a great character.
Not Superman!
I first saw Superman on television, the George Reeves TV series. I just loved it. I guess it was the idea of flying.
George Reeves would run up and bounce out the window. I would try to mimic that. I mean, who didn't?
Some have seen Superman as a mythic symbol of hope, strength, and moral certainty, while others would simply call him a pop culture phenomenon.
I mean, it's not like I asked to be famous.
Yeah, well, it's the price you pay.
Throughout his history, he's found himself in touch with the times, and occasionally out of fashion.
Get it, Superman. You just do your thing.
Right on. Lois is in danger. I'm going to split.
But Superman continues to endure as generation after generation have come to know him.
I watched the Justice League cartoon on television. That was really my exposure to Superman.
Thank you for flying Superman Airlines.
And with each new generation, Superman continues to challenge our collective notion of what it means to be a hero.
There's always time for heroes. It's the spirit of Superman. It's someone that people can aspire to be.
The guy down the street wanted to be a sports jock. I wanted to save Metropolis.
It's about having a hero who swoops down and saves you. Who looks pretty good, too.
He enables you to do everything humanly possible that we all want to do. It's the greatest fantasy in the world.
She needs help.
But how could you register her with that mutant control agency as if she were some sort of criminal?
The agency isn't a prison, Martha. It's an outreach program to help these unfortunate people. It's for her own good. You know I love her.
But what will happen to her now?
I don't know. Let's just hope the neighbors never find out our beautiful Jubilee's a mutant. They'd never understand it.
Why is this happening to me? I used to be a normal kid. It's not my fault.
Mm-hmm.
God tell the truth in here? Look at somebody say, he going to tell it whether you like it or not. Now, I got to do this piece. I hope y'all can see that now. Now, this is very important, and we're going to, I'm going to talk to you just for a minute, and we're going to go into the questions and answers, but this is a very important thing. Now, this is Dr. Roy H. Williams, and he did research on the brain, and he actually discovered some things that are really going to help us understand what's going on with the brain. He's with a company called the Wizard of Ads, and what they do is they give seminars on how to effectively advertise to people. So they know the whole neurological makeup of the brain, and they can tell you what stimulates it, how you can sell product. You know, you can see certain commercials now and your lips just start getting crusty and white because you can't figure out what's happening. You just ate and still want what they have. That's because they have researched and they understand you and they know how to get in your head and make you want something. Well, this guy is very smart. He's a Christian guy, and his research is very extensive in this, but he concludes that there is a left brain and a right brain. Now, your left brain, the left part of your brain, is known to them as the skeptic. It's the conscious thought, the logical analysis, you know, your awareness. You know, it uses methods and rules. So this is the part of your brain that just does not accept everything. You know, it's the skeptic. It sits back and it just deciphers through different things. And he's saying that the right brain is your subconscious thought, which is, it kind of receives everything. It's always recording. It's always receiving. And then it brings it to the left brain, and the left brain will kick out what it doesn't want. Okay, y'all understand what I'm saying? But what he concludes is that the right brain, if influenced by music... Okay, he says that if you put it to music, if you put the thought, if you put the conception or whatever you have to music, then your right brain through music will actually influence your left brain. So he's saying that music bypasses the guardianship of the left brain. So your right brain can actually influence you through music. So that means that I could sit up here and talk to you like I'm talking now, and some of you will receive it, some of you won't. But if I put what I'm saying to music, you cannot reject it. Y'all listening to me? So, in other words, what it's saying is that when these guys put their messages of their doctrinal beliefs and their messages of murder and death and killing and sexual images and all this stuff, even watching a music video, you may watch it and say, well, I'm just watching it. I'm not going to do anything. But because it's put to music, it is actually.